I am going to be sharing with you guys shipping information. If you're wondering how you set up your Shopify account to do like automatic rates for shipping, how to do flat rate shipping, how to set up your shipping on your Shopify account, that is what I'm going to be going over today. This is going to be beginner friendly and in-depth because I have been getting a ton of questions about when you guys see me click literally like ship and I print my shipping label. You guys are asking me, how did you set that up? How did you do that where your customers are able to select which shipping method they want and check out? Like, how did you set that up? You guys have been emailing me, DMing me. So if you guys would like to learn more, make sure to keep watching and please make sure you guys subscribe so you do not miss out on any more information. And with the fall months coming, and then the holiday season, you need to get shipping set up and ready to go because normally you guys will see a boost in your profits, in your orders, and your sales when it comes to the holidays. So you don't want to miss out on that opportunity because your website wasn't set up. So I'm actually going to screen record my screen so you guys can go step by step with me at home. Make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up if you like it so I know to create more tutorials like this for you guys. But let's go ahead and jump in and get started. Okay, so we are in my Shopify store account. All I did was go to settings down here at the bottom, and that is where it brought me to this page. Next, I am gonna head over to shipping and delivering. So this is how I'm going to set everything up. Now, mind you, mine's gonna look a little different, but I will walk you through everything. I am first going to scroll down, and the first thing I would set up is your packages. This is where you guys always ask me, how did I set up what my packages, how much they weigh, what packages I'm going to be using, because I had a question somebody asked me, okay, I use a box, for example, to ship my orders. How do I add the shipping of the actual box, because the box is heavy, how do I add that to my order? Because if you just weigh your items, it's going to be heavier because you have to account for what you're shipping it in. So I hope that makes sense. You're going to just go here and click add package. So is it a box, an envelope, a satchel, soft package? You're going to enter in all of the information here. And then here, you're going to actually put how much it weighs. It says optional, but I highly recommend you weigh it, literally weigh your packaging and put it here. You can customize a name too. Like for instance, if you want to put poly mailer large here, or like poly mailer small, just for your own records, I recommend that you do that. You can set it as a default too, which means that automatically it'll account for that shipping. Or let's say you're going to do, this is kind of like what I've used before too, but let's say you're going to use like boxes from USPS. Remember I showed you guys how you can get free packages from USPS. You can get free shipping packages from USPS. So let's say you wanted to use those. You could select which ones you're going to use so it'll automatically account for those packages. So then when you're done, you're going to click add package. Super, super simple and easy. But if you have a customized package, you click here. Or if you have a carrier package, you click here. So then make sure you click add package. Next is going to scroll up to right here, these delivery methods. Now, this is kind of the most important part. You want to make sure that you got this part right. Okay, so now it might look a little bit different for you, but I'm going to click manage rates. Okay, now this is where you're going to pick where you can ship to. So if you want to ship only in the United States, or if you want to only ship to Mexico or Brazil, whatever you want to do, that is what you're gonna do here. Don't mind any of this stuff. It's because, remember I showed you guys checked out my video on how to actually add products to your Shopify store. Here, remember I put in my weight of my items. So that's what this is, okay? But we can ignore this, this is my setup. Okay, now for me personally, I have shipping to Canada and the US and the rest of the world set up. That's just how I'm doing it. These are just the four regions that I don't supply to, but you can do this however you want. I'm going to show you how you can set it up. Now again, yours is going to look different than mine, but you're going to click create shipping zone. Okay.
You can select, let's say I only wanted this to be in the United States, right? This is what I'm going to create. Let's just say I'm going to use this for example, although I'm not going to, but because I already have all the other zones set up on my account. So let's say I wanted this French Southern Territories. So let me change this to French. Okay. Then I'm going to click done. Okay. So I got a flag on it because I really can't ship there, but you're going to click here and you're going to add rates. So this, you guys, is where you set up your shipping rates, okay? So you can either set up your own shipping rates. Like, let's say you just want $5 flat rate shipping. You can add that here. Or free shipping. Let's say you price your products where everything ships free. You can do that here. You can add the price here. If you want $5 flat rate shipping, you can enter conditions here. So, like, you can get $5 shipping if you spend minimum of $20. You know what I mean? So you can this is where you customize all of this. And let's say, but you can only make sure you don't go over $50. Because if you go over 50, you got to pay for extra shipping. Or is items are usually based on weight. That's really good too if you have like heavy items that you want to ship. Heavy items are hard to ship. So, but you can, this is how you set up shipping rates, okay? But I am going to use this one, and this is what I personally use on my website. And again, everybody's is different, but I use the carrier apps to calculate this. How I do this is I will use USPS most of the time. I use DHL for, I think, my international, but most of the time I use USPS. And here, which is great, rates are based on your customer's address and weight. So basically, for me and my website, pretty much my customers pay for shipping. So for instance, I know a lot of people love that I ship internationally, but if you are international, you have to pay for your own shipping. So I know international people like really hate that because shipping is usually really expensive, but it's less cost on me because sometimes the shipping is actually more than what they even purchased from my store, so I'm losing money. And then two, I would click automatically show new shipping services when they become available. That's just in case anything changes, it'll automatically update to your website. Another thing that I do is I do have a handling fee. There is a handling packaging fee. I believe I have mine set up for international, or let's say you are gonna just use this right here, right? You're just going to use this. This is how you're going to set it up. You're gonna do it by weight and dimensions of their order, okay? But you know what? This, let's say the way you priced your items, you didn't account for actual shipping cost of buying your shipping items. So maybe here you wanna do 15% of what they order is what they're gonna get added to. So this is for packing and handling costs. So let's say you don't account for it, everybody's different, but if you do account for it, you can add the percentage here. You can price your items higher to account for shipping, or you can just do a flat rate shipping to account for the cost of your shipping. It's completely up to you and how you wanna do it. There's no right way, you just wanna make sure you're making profit, okay? So after you're done, you click done, but that's pretty much how you set up the shipping. So let me show you guys how I have mine set up just so you can see. Okay. I have free shipping set up for United States if you spend more than $40. When I have big sales, a lot of people take advantage of this, which is a great opportunity for you to boost your sales. You can kind of encourage people to buy more. So this is what I have set up. You don't have to do $40. Like, let's say you're selling like lip glosses. People aren't going to buy $40 of lip gloss. Like if you know, it just depends on your item. So maybe you want to do $20 minimum price and you get free shipping. So that's something that you can do. I have my services set up. So I told, like before when you guys saw, you can add in your shipping rates and your service provider. I have USPS. And for example, I have first class packages, which is normally the cheapest. You guys will need to do research and see what works best for you and the products that you ship, because I use a poly mailer. I do not use boxes. I've kind of set mine up and figured it out. I do offer priority mail. I don't do priority mail express because that's just, nobody even buys that. That's ridiculously expensive. But like priority mail, in case people want it ASAP, they are willing and they want to buy priority mail. And I have had a handful of people who will do this, but if they want their products ASAP, they can pay for priority mail. That's what this is. And of course, I have it set up where they automatically add new services when they become available. And I'm right now just charging 10%. I do need to increase my shipping prices now that the holidays are coming, because rates at the USPS packaging usually kind of go up too with the holidays. So I will be adjusting this, but this is just an example of mine and how mine's set up. So normally when you buy from me and you're from the United States, the shipping carrier I have set up is USPS. So you can set up multiple shipping, like for example, like how I have mine, DHS for the rest of the United Kingdom. I have a DHL for the rest of the world, USPS, but I also have first class international packaging if they want to pay for it. These are just giving my customers an option, and this is how everything is kind of set up, okay? Now, if you have a delivery or pickup location, you can set that up here as well. I don't offer pickup and I do not do delivery, but let's say you make baked goods or something and you want people to come pick them up, you can set that up right here. Now, the shipping labels. This automatically is set up based on what you put in on the delivery methods checkout. That's where this is from, okay? So I have DHS or DHL, USPS, and UPS, so I do get discounts. There are other apps and other ways you can do this. It might be cheaper, it might not be, I don't know. I just use Shopify because it's quick and it's easy. So you can use, now this is if you're using a desktop printer that'll just print your labels on a piece of paper, or a label printer like I have that I shared with you that I use for my small business. Now, packing slips, you can edit and customize them if you'd like. I don't touch any of this stuff, but you can go in and let's say you want to change it, and then you have to go into coding. So yeah, I'm not crazy about that, but that is how shipping works. It's pretty simple. You just need to set it up and then you're kind of done. You don't need to do more than that, you guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found value. Let me know if you have any other questions though, and I definitely can get back to you on those, or if I need to make another video, I can too. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you in my next video.